Hello, welcome to Fair Trade Finder. Today we're diving into the world of portable power stations for EV charging. As more people use electric vehicles, the need for places to charge them, especially in remote areas, keeps growing. One of the key challenges in owning an electric vehicle is making sure that you have enough battery power to get from point A to point B, especially in areas where charging stations might be scarce. That's where portable power stations come in. While portable rechargeable batteries are not a substitute for a dedicated EV charging station, they can provide you valuable energy in a pinch. Using a portable power station to fully recharge your electric vehicle would be time-consuming and inefficient. However, portable power stations can offer a boost. This makes them a good backup option for unexpected moments when you need just a little extra power to reach your destination or a charging station. First up in this video, we'll explore the essential features you should consider when selecting a portable power station for charging your. And second, we'll provide estimate on how much mileage some of the most popular portable power stations can deliver to an electric vehicle. Before we get started, please hit those like and subscribe buttons. Also, if you're interested in taking a look at any of the power stations in this video, check out the video description for product links. I'm an Amazon and REI affiliate, and we'll get a little commission if you decide to make a purchase. It costs you nothing and helps me make more videos. So now, let's jump in. So different electric vehicles have different charging needs, and you need to match your portable power station to make sure that it can efficiently charge your car. Before we get into the list of power stations, let's review a few key features to look out for. The first one is output. So the output of a portable power station determines how long it will take to charge the EV, and this value is measured in kilowatts. The higher the output, the faster you can charge your electric vehicle. Next is capacity. Capacity is the amount of energy a battery can store, and this tells you how many additional miles the power station can deliver to the EV. Capacity is measured in kilowatt hours. Larger capacity in the portable power station allows you to provide more mileage. To find out how long it'll take to charge an EV using a power station, we divide the EV's battery capacity by the portable power station's output, or the EV's DC fast charge capability. I'll explain what that is in a little bit. To calculate how many additional miles a power station can provide, we divide the portable power station's capacity by the EV's energy consumption rate. Next, let's look at how to efficiently charge an EV. And you'll need some specific equipment, because one of the biggest downsides of using a portable power station is that under normal circumstances, it takes a really long time and it wouldn't be worth the wait. For this reason, it's vital that you use something called DC fast charging. So DC fast charging, or level 3 charging, delivers direct current power straight to your EV's battery. EVs have different levels that they can charge, and each level has a different speed. Level 1 is the slowest, and level 3 is one of the fastest. So this method bypasses the onboard charger, and it allows for much quicker charging times. The equipment that you need to efficiently charge your electric vehicle with power station is the EV charger adapter and specific charging cables. This will be something like CCS or NACS or CHAdeMO connectors. You don't need to buy these from the portable power station maker or the EV maker. You can get them through third-party sources, but you have to make sure that they match the requirements. Now let's review our list of top portable power stations for EV charging. Number one, let's start with the EcoFlow Delta Pro and look at how it charges the Hyundai IONIQ 5. So the EcoFlow Delta Pro has capacity and output of 4,000 kilowatt hours. It weighs 113 pounds, or about 51.5 kilograms. And this is another important feature to take note of, because all of these power stations are going to be pretty heavy. When you are traveling in an electric vehicle, obviously weight is very important, because it'll diminish your efficiency and increase your energy consumption. So just to compare how regular charging stacks up against DC fast charging, let's look at if we were to just regularly charge the Hyundai IONIQ 5, we would get about 13 miles of additional range and it would take 21 hours, which is completely not worth it. And that's just using the power station's regular output of about 3,600 kilowatts. Sorry, 4,000 kilowatts. Now, if we use the DC fast charge option, we can get that same additional mileage in 20 minutes, which is totally worth it. So 20 minutes to get you 13 miles, which should get you to either a charging facility so that you can properly charge the car, or to wherever your destination is. From this point on, we're just going to be looking at DC fast charge, and we're just going to disregard the regular charging option because it's just way too slow. Next, moving on to the Jackery Explorer 5000 Plus and looking at how it would charge the Rivian R1T. So the Rivian is the largest EV on our list. It's a pickup truck. It has a pretty large battery capacity of 106,000 kilowatt hours. In 28 minutes using the DC fast charge, the Jackery Explorer 5000 Plus can get you an additional 10 miles of travel range. So not a lot. However, again, the point of this is not to fully recharge your EV, but just to give you an extra boost so that you can either reach your destination or reach a charging facility. Third on our list is the Goal Zero Yeti 6000X. So this has a 6,000 kilowatt hours capacity and 3,500 kilowatt output. And we're going to use it to charge the BMW i4e Drive 35 series. This is on the larger side in terms of EVs. It has a capacity of 83,000 kilowatt hours. So in about 28 minutes, using the DC fast charge, we can get 26 miles of additional range. That's pretty good. And the BMW, it's a kind of a beast of a car. It gives you up to about 300 miles of range. I really like the Goal Zero for this. It's 106 pounds, which is actually a little bit on the lighter side compared to some of the other power stations we're looking at. I also really like the wheels that you have. It's very sturdy. It's kind of built for travel. So I think it delivers a good amount of capacity and output. Next, let's move on to the EcoFlow Delta Pro 3 and the Volkswagen ID4. In this example, we are expanding the capacity of the EcoFlow Delta Pro 3 from about 4,000 kilowatt hours up to 8,000. This is a scalable power station, and you can add battery packs to increase your capacity. So this, with 8,000 kilowatt hours of capacity and 4,000 kilowatts of output using DC fast charge, in about 28 minutes, we can get 27 additional miles. In this example, I would say the Yeti Goal Zero that we just looked at is a much better option for this, because with the EcoFlow Delta Pro, you have the power station, which is 113 pounds, plus an additional battery pack, which is an additional 72 pounds. You're looking at almost 200 pounds of additional weight to get 27 miles. So next, let's look at, once again, I think this is my favorite power station in my list, the Goal Zero Yeti 6000X. About 100 pounds, 6,000 watts of capacity, 3,500 kilowatts of output. In 19 minutes, you can get an additional 30 miles. And this is with the Kia EV6. Now the Kia is one of the smaller EVs on our list. It has battery capacity of 77,000 kilowatt hours, and the energy consumption is about 5 miles per kilowatt hour. But the Yeti Goal Zero is so much more efficient, considering you just need one device and can get you an additional 30 miles of range. So thanks for watching this video. Please leave comments if you have experience. If I've made any mistake, let me know. And I will be back soon with another video.